think?
I think Santa must have gotten my letter.
Oh, stop it.
Never seen you in anything quite like that. I mean, the dress that...
Don, this is not a dress. This is a uniform.
I beg your pardon?
This is for my job at the Pelican. What have I done? Oh, can I hold him?
Oh, with cracked ribs, what are you, crazy?
Okay, well, thanks for bringing him in and bending the rules.
Well, you know, the nurses have been bugging me to bring him in, and besides, I thought he'd cheer you up. I know this isn't exactly where you wanted to be on Christmas Eve.
It's been all right. I've been doing a lot of thinking.
Do you mind if I ask him? What about?
A lot of things. About Vicky.
Well, I hope those presents are all for me. And Bridget. Where is she?
She went to Christmas Eve services. She'll be back in a while.
Well, Angela took little Michael with some of her friends to go Christmas caroling. Oh. He loves that this year.
Yeah, I'll bet he does.
Oh, you have a tree.
Yes, Evan brought it by.
Evan?
Mm-hmm, he just left.
Whose idea was the candy?
Evan's. All the Christmas trees in the world can't change the fact that this Christmas stinks.
I just want it to be over. I long for December the 26th.
Jamie decided not to send me to jail. But he made it very clear that I probably won't be able to see Stephen tomorrow or any other day. But I knew it could happen. I knew that when I brought him back. And I know that bringing him back was the right thing to do.
Yes, it was. And things are going to change for both of us. I promise that. I promise. I promise.
Why don't you get that?
All right. I'll get some eggnog.
All right.
A little good cheer.
Yes.
Donna.
Michael.
Well, Merry Christmas.
Right.
Look, I just brought some presents over. Yeah, come here.
Look, whoever you are, you should better get out of here, okay? I mean it, you scuzzbucket!
What would the little kiddies think if they learned you took out Santa with a fifth of bonded bourbon?
I recognize that lousy, stinking voice.
Ho, ho, ho.
I'll give you ho, ho, ho.
Now, Frank,
do you know
calm
I should
down.
Beat lumps into your head? You scared me half to death.
Oh, you get over it.
You had Felicia call me, didn't you?
I wanted to spend Christmas Eve with you, and I knew if I asked you myself, you would have turned me down.
Oh, so you just figured you'd arrange things, huh? Well, I have a newsflash for you, pal. It didn't work.
Frankie.
And you look ridiculous in that outfit.
Frankie.
What?
That elevator isn't going to come.
Why not?
Security. The guards have the rest of the night off. They shut off the elevator at 7 o'clock, sharp.
It's 7:05.
Yes, I know. So, looks like we're stuck here.
For how long?
Until morning.
Stairs. There have got to be Frankie? Stairs. I don't care how many there are.
Frankie!
Worth the trip. What?
The doors all get locked, too.
What happens if there's a fire? What if someone decides to take one of these candles and turn you into a human Yule log?
Speaking of candles.
If you think you are going to sucker me in...
With a delicious cold supper when you haven't had anything to eat since breakfast? Nah.
That's not true.
Frankie, I know you. You skip lunch.
This is low. Even for you, Winthrop.
Smoked salmon, asparagus vinaigrette, cold. I even got you a Bûche Noël. Now, when was the last time you shared a Bûche Noël by candlelight, huh?
I don't care if you got Bush, Noel. I don't care if you've got Barbara Bush. I wouldn't eat with you if you were the last man on Earth. Got it?
Michael, I'm not going to be here for very long.
Dad!
Don't you think you could come back so I
can... Dad! Come on in.
Thank you. These are for you and Stephen.
Thank you. Why don't we all have some eggnog?
Did your friend do your Christmas shopping
Mom,
for you this year?
Mom, this Christmas is bad
enough. Donna, please. I tell you what, I have this feeling I should have called before I came over, so why don't I just go, and maybe I'll come back tomorrow, okay?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. Jake.
Hey, I was just about to knock.
I didn't expect to see you again today.
Well, I was looking for Donna, and she wasn't home, so I thought she might be here.
Yes, she is.
Yeah, on the way home, I passed a toy store, and I... Not that I was looking for anything for myself, but I picked up Babar the Elephant. Like, he's always wanting us to read those stories to him, so...
Oh, that was very thoughtful of you.
Seeing a lot of my family these days, Jake, a lot more than when you were married to Marley. I wonder why.
It's Christmas.
Jake, ignore him. Come on in. Come on.
Excuse me. I'll call you tomorrow.
So, I see Evan bought you a Christmas tree, huh?
Jake, he's a friend.
First he drives you to Lassiter, then he buys you a Christmas tree, but you're still friends.
Why don't you join us for some eggnog and cookies?
As long as Evan's not here, why not?
You can get yourself a glass. The cookies are in a tray. You don't mind, do you?
For you two ladies.
I think you were a little rough on Dad.
Why shouldn't I be? He's probably on his way over to her right now.
I know. He's supposed to be in love with another woman.
He is in love with another woman.
Then why was he so green with jealousy when Jake walked in?
I don't want you getting involved with Vicky, Mom, especially not now.
I'm not going to get involved with her. I just want to talk to her, sound her out about a few things.
Well, good luck.
I feel very hopeful about a lot of things this time of year.
Well, I start any kind of conciliatory move, and I feel like a sucker.
People can change, Jamie.
I know they can.
When I was younger, taking care of you all by myself, I did a lot of things I regret.
Because you were alone?
Partially. When you're lonely, it changes your perspective on a lot of things.
Well, am I supposed to excuse Vicky because she's alone? Is that what you're saying, Mom?
No.
Because I'm alone, too. And so are you. But we don't act the way she acts.
We have a lot of support from our family. Once you've been burned by life, sometimes it seems safer not to take a chance on it anymore.
I'm doing this for him. Come here.
I know that. I'm not just talking about you, you know.
Are you sure?
I'm talking about me, too. Yeah, you're right. I am alone again. But this time, it's going to be different.
Mrs. Corey is much improved. No, sir. I can't say when she'll be released.
Excuse me, can you tell me who that was?
No, I'm sorry, I can't.
It's okay, I'm close to the Corey family. Matthew Corey's my son.
Oh, no, it's not that. That guy that calls.
Does he call often?
Well, yeah, he calls about Mrs. Corey, but he never leaves his name.
You know, there's nothing quite like Irish smoked salmon. I thought you'd like to know that, because I remember you once mentioned that salmon, smoked salmon, was your very favorite thing in the world. And I wanted you to know that I did get the best for you. Delicious. My taste buds are exploding.
I hope it chokes you.
What?
I was just musing about how long it would take you to get bored with this stupid macho plan of yours and let me go.
Hey, I told you, it's not me. Everything's shut up tight.
Well, then I guess there's only one thing left to do.
I knew you'd see it my way. Fine, you read, and I'll eat. Of course, we could talk. I mean, we could try to straighten things out, and then maybe you'd feel like you could share this with me.
We talked before.
Okay. Oh, I called the hospital. Rachel's doing a lot better.
Yeah, I know. I spoke to her, too.
She still doesn't remember who rescued her.
What about that clown you hired to investigate? Doesn't he know anything?
No. He took that night off.
Oh, good.
Of course, if you had been on the case...
I'll be on the case.
Oh, great.
But I'll have to report directly to Rachel. I will not work with you.
You know, what we need is some music to
What
pep
I
us up.
Need is distance and lost...
I wonder if Felicia has any Christmas tapes here. Nat King Cole, what could be more perfect? Oh, I see you got off your stool.
I was looking for the fire door.
Oh, well, it's not over that way. It's over this way.
Oh, good. Well, now I know where it is.
What are you hiding, Frankie?
Nothing.
You have something behind your back?
An Uzi. You want to chance it?
Come on, Frankie. Show me. Come on. I knew it. I knew it. Like I said, Irish is the best.
You're sadist, Winthrop.
Hey, why didn't you leave?
What?
The door to the stairs. You could have made it while I had my back turned.
You said it was locked.
Maybe I was just saying that. Maybe it's not.
Maybe I didn't want to faint on my way down the stairs.
Is that it? Or were you looking to get enough sustenance for a long night ahead?
Boy. Ah, your ego just never quits, does it?
You don't want to leave, Frankie. You know it, and I know it. Now, why don't you join me for dinner? Please.
John, I'm not sure about this. Are you furious?
No, that's not the word I would use.
I mean, John, be in public like this.
Yeah.
John, people are going to see me.
At the Pelican Club. Right.
No, they're not. No, they are not, because I'm not going out that door dressed like
this. Good, Charlie. No idea how glad I am that you said that.
Really?
Really. I must admit, though, I mean, it is... It's different.
Well, I like the old me. Didn't you like the old me?
Well, yes, I like the old you, the one I married just 2 weeks ago. Of course, that's the one I like.
Well, I'm wondering whether I'm going to be comfortable prancing around the Pelican Club like this.
Well, if they insist that you wear it, take some comfort in the fact that you will also be wearing this.
Do you think I'd forget that?
Well, I would hope not.
What?
I'm just thinking how sorry I am that I have to work tonight, and this could be a very memorable Christmas Eve.
Silver bells are ringing. Okey-dokey.
Carolers are singing. Snowflakes drifting through the air.
It is patently ridiculous for your father to be jealous of Chief.
Hey, Vicky, where's the tape at?
In the drawer next to the sink.
I'm telling you, I saw his face.
Well, I appreciate you trying to bolster up my ego.
That's not what I'm doing.
Although, just the idea that your father would be jealous of Jake.
I know you guys would never... I mean... But I know you're friends, and you're working together, and it bothers Dad.
Well, the fact of the matter is that your father doesn't care about me anymore. And when I think that little Michael has to face that for
the rest of his
life.
He doesn't have to face it because it's not true.
Anyone ever tells you that it's easy to wrap an elephant, you just tell him to come see me.
It hurts, Dad, that he's doing this to you.
Oh, then why is he doing it?
I don't know.
I know why. He found family life distracting for a while, and now he doesn't. I'm going to call Angela, see if she's brought little Michael back home yet.
I knew she would do this.
What?
Give up on Dad. Treat him like she doesn't care about him anymore.
tell you the truth, Vicky, I don't care a whole hell about anymore what happens to Michael.
You always liked him, Jake.
Are you kidding me? I worshipped him. I always thought Donna was some lucky society girl that had snagged him. I mean...
Yeah.
To me, Michael was the kind of guy that didn't take crap from anybody, but he'd go to the wall if he cared about you.
He is like that.
No, he's not. Donna's not telling you everything. I mean, first you were all tied up with Steven, and then you took off?
It's killing him that he's doing this to her.
Vicky, I was there the day that Michael humiliated her in front of everybody.
Well, I don't believe it, Jake.
You know what I don't believe, Vic? I don't believe I was wrong. I mean, she is the one with guts. She is the one that deserves someone better than Michael.